In this video, I'm going to walk through the process of using the provided homework driver files inside of Eclipse. When you're given a driver or tester file with your homework, I strongly recommend that you use that file. The tester is designed to help you make sure that your code is working correctly. I include tests to help find the most common mistakes, so it's in your best interest to run that driver program. The program might look a little overwhelming at first, but I'm going to break it down step by step here, and hopefully once you start using them, you'll get used to the setup and be able to use them easily to help you with your homework. And after all, that's what they're there for, to help you test your own code. The first thing to do is to download the provided file. Sometimes it will be a single .java file, but often it will be a zip, meaning that I am giving you multiple files. When you download the zip, make sure you unzip the files before you use them. So you won't be able to use the files inside of the zip correctly. You have to unzip or extract them in order to use them. Once you've done that, you can add your files to Eclipse. So I'm going to create a new Java project to use for this example. I'll call it Homework Driver Demonstration. If you're using an older version of Eclipse, it will next ask you if you want to create a model.info file. I recommend always clicking Don't Create. If you have a newer version of Eclipse, just make sure that this checkbox here saying Create Module-Info.java file is unchecked. This just keeps things simpler in terms of project structure. Now that you've got your project, you can just drag your files from your unzipped folder and drop them onto the .source folder in Eclipse. So that's right here. And I can just select these all and drag and drop them. It's going to ask me if I want to copy or link, and I select copy. And that's all there is to do to add them to Eclipse. So now if I open up this package, I see all of the provided homework files. So let's start with an overview of the driver file. Usually at the top, there'll be a place for you to write your own code that you're writing for the assignment. For this assignment, the first question was write a complete method that takes in two integer parameters and returns the absolute value of the sum of the parameters. So in Eclipse here, you can see that this is the method header for the method that I'm asking you to write. If that method returns a value, there'll be a placeholder statement to return some value. This is only there so that the program will compile and you can run your tests. You should replace this placeholder statement with your own code once you write the method. After the place where you write your own code will be the main method. And this is the code that runs the actual test. I'll return to this in a moment. If you look beyond main, you'll find a set of test methods listed down here with a little message before them saying, essentially, don't worry about these methods. These methods at the bottom of the file run the automated tests of your code. They're there to streamline the test cases and run the tests, but you do not need to read, modify, use, or understand this code in any way. You can essentially just ignore all of these test methods completely. Now, of course, if you want to review these methods and you have questions, you can, of course, ask. But otherwise, you can safely ignore all of the test methods at the end of the driver program. What you want to focus on instead is the code in the main method. This is the code that will show you what tests are being run. In this example, I can see that I'm testing the absolute value of sum method, and you can see that I have several calls to my tester method that's called test absolute value of sum. Note that it's this tester method, the one I said you can ignore, that actually calls your method. If you go back down to the bottom here to look at test absolute value of sum, you'll see that there's the call to the actual method that you're going to write. The statement in main calls this tester method, and this tester method calls your method. Now, I said you don't have to look at the tester method, so how does this work? Well, in the comments, I'll tell you what the parameters in these test calls mean. In this example, the first two parameters are the numbers to be summed. So these are the two numbers that get passed to your actual method. The third parameter is the expected result. So this is the value that your method should return. And the fourth parameter is a description of that particular test case. So you can see in this example that we're running a test for two positive numbers, two negative numbers, one positive, one negative, one negative, one positive, and so on. What this line here is essentially saying is invoke my absolute value of sum method, sending in 1 and 4, and test to see if you get back a 5. Then I'm saying now invoke it with a negative 3 and negative 8, and test to see if you get back 11. Then run it with 2 and negative 4, and test to see if you get back 2, and so on. So that's how the general setup works. When you're ready to get started, you'll come to the method placeholder and write your actual code. You'll get rid of that placeholder code and replace it with your own. So I'm going to implement the method here, and I'm just going to say return the absolute value of x plus y. Now, I'm going to run the tester, and when I do that, I get a lot of output. The bottom of the output is a summary that tells me that all of the automated tests have passed. If I scroll up to the top, I'll get some more information. So this tells me what method is being tested, and it gives me a description of each test along with the expected result and my actual result. So for example, the absolute value of 1 plus 4, expected result is 5, actual result is 5. Expected value of negative 3 plus negative 8, expected result is 11, actual result is 11, and so on. This allows you to compare the answer you should have gotten with the answer your code produced. Now, note that some driver programs will have output here that you have to check and compare manually that isn't an automated test, but I will always have a note in the homework that tells you when that happens. So let's go back and change the method so that it doesn't return the correct value. Let's pretend that I forgot to take the absolute value and just returned x plus y. Now when I run the driver program, you can see first that the summary message at the bottom is telling me that something failed, that there's a failure in at least one of the automated tests. When I scroll back up, I can look through the test that failed. So some of the tests will have this message here, test failed, along with that test description telling me which test it is that failed. The idea here is that these descriptions should provide you some sort of clue as to what went wrong. In this case, I might notice that all of the test cases that failed involved negative numbers, at least one negative number. So that might give me a clue that I need to do something related to positive versus negative numbers. And that's essentially how you use the tester. Now, most times there'll be more than one homework question. So if we look back at this homework, there is actually a second question. Write a complete method that returns whether or not a number is even. So actually, the driver program I would have given you would look actually more like this. It's the same setup, but here there are now two places for you to write your method since you're writing two separate methods. Inside of main, there are two groups of testing statements. And down at the bottom, in those methods that you can ignore, there's more than there were before. In this case, there's two tester methods that you can ignore. When there are multiple methods like this, the driver runs the same way. However, let's say you decide to implement the absolute value method first, and let's say you write your correct implementation, and you run the driver. You're going to get a lot of failed tests from that second method, the one you haven't written yet. And that might make it hard to focus on the results of the first test, the first method. So what I recommend doing is going into your main method and commenting out all of the test cases for the questions you aren't working on, like this. You can highlight them, and you can either do on a PC, you can do control backslash, or you could use the block comment in Java, which is the slash with the asterisk. Either way, to basically comment out that entire block of tests. And now when I run the program, I can focus on the output only for the question I'm working on now. And once I get that solved, I can then comment out the test cases for that one, uncomment out the test cases for the next one that I want to work on. So this will allow you not to get too bogged down in a ton of output and just focus on one question at a time. So that's really how I recommend using these. Hopefully this helps you understand how to use the driver programs. If you have any questions about how to use them or how to interpret the result, please ask. I do strongly recommend that you use the drivers as I carefully choose these test cases to help you find and fix the most common mistakes and bugs. I'm also always trying to make them more user-friendly, so please do let me know if you have any questions or suggestions for improvement.